Listen up, ask yourself, are you constantly in a bad mood? Do you suddenly have an increased appetite? Well, if so, you may not be getting enough sleep. Joining us this morning is pharmacist Dr. Stephanie Young Moss, discussing the signs we can look for and natural ways to get us some help. Good morning to you, Dr. Stephanie.
Hi, good morning.
Hello,
how are you?
I'm doing okay. So this has been a topic of our discussion throughout this morning on Indy Style. We're asking people if they typically get the recommended 8 hours of sleep. Most people say no. Do you find that to be the case as well?
Yes, there are many adults that are not getting a lot of sleep, especially the recommended hours of sleep between 7 and 9 from the National Sleep Association.
Okay.
They're not getting that sleep. So they are having a lack of focus, a lack of concentration,
absolutely,
especially during these times right now.
Okay, well, let's go through these signs that you aren't getting enough sleep. It sounds kind of silly, but the first one you say, if you feel like you're in a bad mood all the time, or at least that you feel like you've been like that lately, it might just be you need to go back to bed.
Exactly. So a lot of times you think you're getting 7 to 9 hours of sleep because you're in the bed for 7 to 9 hours.
Oh, yeah.
However, you're not getting constant sleep, or we're not getting that full amount of sleep that we need to actually help our bodies rejuvenate and help our minds rejuvenate. So that is one of the signs. If you're in a bad mood recently, that could be because of anything, but you need to really monitor your sleep and see if that could be a cause as well.
And you also talk about that. It kind of correlates with productivity. If you find that you have lower productivity, perhaps all of a sudden.
Yes, all of a sudden productivity loss, which comes with that lack of concentration, all of that plays into that lack of sleep. So that can also affect your mood. So insomnia is also correlated with anxiety and depression. So you will see some of those signs and symptoms that you may have a lack of sleep.
Okay, this next one is interesting to me. You say you might not be getting enough sleep if you have an increased appetite.
Yes, some people do not realize that your appetite can be associated with you not sleeping enough. So if you've noticed an increase in your appetite lately, which a lot of us have been going back and forth to the fridge during the pandemic, I'm sure.
Yeah.
But if you notice that it's unusual,
your
lack of sleep can actually cause the hunger hormone, ghrelin, to go up, which makes you feel hungry all the time. So getting that sleep will help reduce that hormone and help you not feel as hungry all the time.
Okay.
And it also increases your craving. So you may want to crave carbs. Think about pancakes, pastries, and pizza. Those types of things, if you're craving that a lot, that could be due to lack of sleep as well.
Sleep affects so many things. You also say your memory is failing. That could be a sign of not getting enough sleep too.
Yes, with your memory, when your brain does not have enough time to rejuvenate or to rest, it will affect your memory, especially your long-term memory. So if you see some of those signs of your long-term memory as of lately has gone down, it could be due to your sleep. So make sure that you get enough sleep to get that long-term memory engaged as well.
Well, of course, we're talking about, what the signs, I guess, that you're not getting enough sleep. And that's easy to say. We could have this list to go on and on. But the next question is, what do you do? And most people would say, well, Amber, go to sleep, right? Get more sleep. But it's a little more complicated than that. And it's not as easy for some people as it perhaps might be for others.
It is. You can do things like make sure that you have a great sleep environment. Is it cool when you go to bed? Not too hot? Do you have a sleep routine that you normally can do? Have the lights dimmed? Do you have maybe a diffuser with some type of essential oil as well? Those types of things will help you really try and get a good night's sleep.
Yeah,
you may even want to read a book or journal before you go to bed as well.
Sure. No, that's a great idea too. And you talk about natural sleep aids as well, something that's not harsh on your body perhaps?
Yes. So it's a good idea to always talk to your doctor, your pharmacist, if you have to take. They do have prescription medications, but I'm going to talk about your natural sleep medications. Those are things that you can do naturally. Like, for instance, melatonin.
Okay.
So melatonin is a natural sleep hormone in your body. And things that decrease melatonin are the blue light from your computer or from your phone. So if you're using those things before you go to bed, it can actually decrease your melatonin. So that is a natural supplement that you can take. If your doctor, your pharmacist recommends it as well, you can take those types of things to help increase your melatonin to get to bed.
And then you say magnesium and vitamin D as well.
Yes, magnesium and vitamin D as well. So magnesium When it comes to magnesium, you can get those types of things in different forms, such as pills or powders, but you can also get it in your food. So you'll find it in things like almonds and bananas and fortified foods like yogurt as well. So those are some good natural ways as well. And then with vitamin D, it's the sun vitamin. And people think, well, if I lay out in the sun, I will get enough vitamin D. However, sometimes it's hard to get that vitamin D. So you may have to take a supplement for that or find it in small amounts of food, such as fish and eggs.
Yeah, and I like the ideas, like you said, of those essential oils too, and just get yourself into that comfortable, relaxing routine to get in that mindset of it's time to go to sleep. Dr. Stephanie Moss, thank you so much for your time. Appreciate it. We'll put all the links to where we can find you on our website, indystyle.tv.
Thank you.
All right, thanks so much.